Hi friends, following is a short review of our trip to Cherai beach. The road which we took, place where we stayed, place where we went for half food, all that we covered, all that will be covered as part of this review. So without much ado, let's start with the route which we took. So basically we started from Thrissur, that's where we started, around 12:30 p.m. As per the map, it tells me that it should take almost 1.5 hours, but it took for us. We started at 12:40 p.m. and we reached the destination around 2:40 p.m., almost 2 hours. So the reason why we took this route instead of the 544 highway, there are three routes you've shown here. 544 was it's a pretty broad and nice highway to drive, but there will be traffic at some point of time. And considering we cover these main places like Chalakudi and Angamali especially, we have a lot of traffic. So, and through North Paravur, we reached this place. So instead, we took the state highway State Highway 22, which goes through Irinyalakuda, Velangannur, Kudungallur, and finally Riya homestay. And that saved us a little bit time. All the roads are a little bit not that wide, and there seems to be a lot of private buses plying this place. You need to keep your eyes and ears open all the time. Okay, but the road, the traffic was much less compared to the 544 highway. So that's the reason why we took this route. It took almost 60 kilometers for us, and we reached the Riya homestay. Now, one thing I want to tell you is that as per Google Maps, if you see, the Riya homestay is shown as, let's zoom in a bit. So as per Google Maps, Riya homestay is over here next to LE Cafe. I'm sure you can see that, okay? So if you see, as per Google Maps, Riya homestay is here, okay? A little bit, so this is the way you would come from Thrissur, and as per Google, it's somewhere here, okay? But in reality, it's not there, okay? In reality, the homestay is right adjacent to this place. Can you see this place here? This is adjacent, right adjacent to this road. This building here would be where your Riya homestay is, and not as marked in the maps. So this is one thing you need to keep in mind. Okay, so now we covered how you could come to this place, to the homestay. Next, let's have a look at the homestay itself and how the room and the facilities provided. Let's go ahead with that. So right from the place where I'm standing, you can have a very good view of the beach as well as the sea. I'm zooming in on the contact person, Mahesh, who owns this place, with whom we confirmed all the details before coming here. Let's have a look at the beach, the locality where this homestay is. The homestay is right adjacent to the main road which connects to Thrissur. If you go just straight in that way, you will reach Thrissur. So I have zoomed into the advertisement. It shows you the name of the place, the email ID, as well as the phone number. You can clearly see those details there. So anytime you want to come over here, just dial up the number. Next, let's have a look at the two adjacent rooms. Ours was the first room. Next to that, there were two other rooms with tables and chairs outside. You could just come out in the evening, listen to the waves and sit there for some time. Those two rooms did not have the air condition. They just have a pedestal fan attached to the wall. I'll show you the kind of fan that I'm talking about. Let's get inside the room. So you can see the mattress they provided us, because we were three members and we wanted an additional mattress. By paying 300 rupees per day, they give an additional mattress, a pillow and a bed sheet. So that's the AC over there. It's a pretty good one. It cools the room in pretty fast. I need to specifically say this because sometimes ACs in Indian homestays don't tend to be that great. Next, we have the pedestal fan, which I was talking about earlier. So here we have the pedestal fan attached to the wall. So this is the only fan available. There are no ceiling fans in any of the rooms. So if you feel the temperature is a little bit high and it's hot or humid, you might need to choose an air-conditioned room instead of a normal room with a pedestal fan. Okay. Let's close the door and go and check out the wardrobe. So out here is the wardrobe. It's pretty spacious for a single room occupant place, and we have enough space for clothes, and you can even keep food items and things like that. Next, let's have a look at the bathroom. The bathroom is pretty clean. The tiles are white, and you have water available all the time. They provide an additional bath towel and soap if requested. The only thing was that there was no hot water available, but we didn't feel that as a big problem because most of the time the water was lukewarm thanks to the hot climate. Even though it was raining most of the time, the climate tend to be a little bit on the hotter side. So here we have the double cot bed again, which I showed you. And the flooring is pretty good, neat. Overall, the rooms are neat, although paint has gone here and there, but it's still manageable. They have nice little wall paintings hanging on the walls of on both the walls. And the room has this cone shape, okay? Almost 10-15 feet extends over above your head, okay? Almost 10 feet it extends above your head. And this nice little hanging light adds to the beauty. So let's check out, let's go downstairs and see how we can have access to the beach. So the stairs take you right to the main road. There was no parking space available as such, but we made use of the parking provided by private people for people who come to the beach. Although they charge 30 rupees for 3 hours, since we were staying for 2 days, they had a discount for us and gave it for 200 rupees for 2 days. So this is the main road which connects, as I told you earlier, which connects to Thrissur. And this is how we come.
So let's step out of the homestay and walk towards the beach. Just a short trip. One thing I observed was that there was a little bit, if you happen to be this place during holidays, there will be a little bit traffic sound, considering the beach is really close by and it's the main road which connects to Cherai to all the other places. So since the homestay is pretty close to that, there will be vehicle sounds, especially during peak hours when people come to visit the beach. So we are at the beach, and pretty good view from here. And right now there is not much people around. Before we end this review, I want to give a small heads up about the couple of places we went to have food. So one was Chili's restaurant. That was a really amazing place, really good food, especially for the people who are interested in non-veg. We tried out crab, fish, and different fish, and chicken. Everything was pretty fine. We enjoyed the food there. Another place is a little bit farther down the road, somewhere here. Yeah, that's where we have the Shivetan's Kada. Shivetan's Hotel, I believe. So, the advantage over there is we have a lot of parking space. Food is pretty cheap. Three people can have meals with prawns curry under 350 rupees. That turns out to be around approximately 100 rupees for each person. But the quality of food is not up to the mark. It's just okay. You can feel your tummy, but the ambience and the place is not that great. It's just ordinary place. You may not prefer going there often. If you're a little bit price conscious and you're okay with the ambience and things like that, it should be pretty fine. That was a short review about our travel to Cherai Beach and our stay. Hope you like it. Bye.